Welcome back to the Barnfine Desert Green Pearl Audi TT Roadster Restoration. Now that the timing chain and water pump has been serviced, the next step is changing the half moon seal and gasket, changing the rear main seal, and sealing the 1.8T back up. First step is to rotate the engine to top dead center so the cam chain tension is in the right spot and the notches on the cam ends align to the arrows on the last cam caps. Mark 16 chain links starting from the left of the exhaust cam notch towards the intake cam. Make any other marks you wish so you know exactly how you need to align the chain back up in relation to the cam sprocket. Now everything is lined up and marked, the cam chain tensioner tool, aka VAG tool number 3366, can be installed. Notice that I'm not using any tool here and screwing it down only by hand. This is really important so that you don't damage the thread where the tool screws into. You'll also see the corner of the plastic hits the head. Do not wind down any further than this. A T30 Torx is required to remove the four bolts holding down the cam chain tensioner. My biggest tip here is to apply downward pressure while cracking the bolts loose to prevent slipping and stripping the head, which I've done before. Once cracked loose, they're easily removed and the cam chain tensioner, along with the tool, can be moved around. You can see I don't have too much slack on my cam chain, but that's okay, there's a way around this. Plus, with this method, you don't have to stress too much about misaligning the cam chain on the sprockets. Remove some tension by rotating the crank counterclockwise a tad, and you'll see the tensioner and cam chain move down like so. This gives just enough wiggle room to service the middle gasket and the half moon seal. That's the easy part done. Remove the half moon seal next with some hook picks. Using hook picks ensures the half moon piece doesn't fall into the head. Go ahead and clean the area up to prepare for the new half moon seal and metal gasket. There's a specific section on the middle gasket that requires some sealant on it. This is the surface that the rubber half moon seal touches. You want to add a thin layer and spread it around. Add some sealant on the flat top surface of the half moon gasket and insert it into the groove. Use the hook picks to ensure the seal is seated in place. You'll see it kind of straddles the shape of the middle half moon hole. The metal gasket can be inserted small end in first. Now, because my chain's tension didn't loosen up a lot, I ended up wiggling the metal gasket in and used my hook picks to ensure that all the bolt holes lined up and the cam chain tensioner sat flush when the gasket's fully in place. As you can see, I had to wiggle the cam chain tensioner unit up and down to get the metal gasket in its correct place. Finally, it slots in place with the help of a flathead screwdriver. Once those two gaskets are in place, you can torque down the four T30 bolts. I'll put all the torque specs in the description below. The cam chain tensioner tool can then be removed, where you want to double check the chain is still aligned to your marks. Okay, so that's the hard part of servicing the head done. Next is to place some dabs of gasket sealant in the joins where the head joins to the cam caps and any angled bends. I've also added some extra dabs on the timing belt side to aid the rubber cam cover gasket to stick down in place, as they're often packed flat and tend to bend the way you don't want it to. Install the gasket, ensuring it sits in the grooves and the built-in half moon seal straddles the head properly. You can see I had to push the gasket into its groove once I've placed the cam cover on, as the way it was bent, it didn't naturally sit in place. Replace the 9 nuts and torque them down to spec, tightening from the center and working in a star-like pattern to get an even pressure on the gasket. I always like to go over them in a line to ensure everything's peachy once I think I've done them all. And then the final part is to install the plastic upper timing chain cover. The top end is sorted, so I flip the engine around to focus on the oil sump. I'm going to change the oil pickup O-ring since it's been disturbed. So there's the part number there for you, and funnily enough, the O-ring is the same as the ones found in the transfer case or bevel box. That's why I've got two in the packet. This is really easy, as you've just got two bolts to take care of. The final part before sealing up the oil pan is to service the rear main seal. It's attached by 6 10mm bolts. The seal can be pried off and a quick cleanup is required since the engine had been sitting for a while. The key here is to ensure the sealing face around the crank is clean and dry. You must ensure there is no traces of oil to guarantee a leak-free seal. Now, the new rear main seal comes with a plastic fitting to help with installation. The important step here is to ensure the Teflon seal doesn't fold back on itself. The plastic application tool really helps to ensure the fitment is correct. There are two locating pins that helps you line up the rear main seal in its correct position. Once fully seated, just double check the seal hasn't folded outwards, otherwise you want to start again. Torque up the bolts and leave the seal to settle for at least 4 hours where you don't turn the engine over. Finally, a thin bead of gasket sealant can be applied around the perimeter of the block, and then the sump can be carefully placed and torqued down to seal the engine up. Again, you want to tighten the bolts in a star-like fashion and leave the gasket to cure before filling up with oil. Now, in my case, it's got plenty of time before I can fill it up, as I still need to get this back into the engine bay anyway. All right, and that's pretty much it. I'm pretty happy now that the engine has been sealed back up again. I'm confident that it's going to run well, and look out for the next video where I'll probably be putting the engine back in. Thanks for watching.